Day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. I hope you remember what has been taught to you in the last class. As you are aware, we do the revision after every class. So this will be your revision class. But before we do that, let us talk a bit about some of the questions. Can you tell what is the difference between font color and highlighting color? You use the font color option when you want to change the color of the line or paragraph that you may have typed. In case you want to change the color appearing behind the text on your page, then you will use the highlighting color option. The highlighting color option changes only the text background color and not of the text itself. Can you tell what are the MINOs and why do we use them? OpenOffice has MINOs for file, edit, view, insert, format, table, and tools. These MINOs help you get your work done, like to save or find something in a file, doing any type of formatting, etc. Since all these options are available in the MINO bars, which is the quick start window in OpenOffice. The window which has options for text documentation, presentation, spreadsheet, drawing, database, etc. is the window which is called as the quick start window. Which shortcut command do you need to use to open the quick start window? On typing SOffice in the run box and pressing the enter key, you see the quick start window which shows you all the components of the OpenOffice. Do you know how, with the help of the standard toolbar, can you convert any file to the PDF format? By clicking on the Export as PDF shortcut option in the standard toolbar, you can convert any file to the PDF format. Can you tell why we use the hyperlink option? Using the hyperlink option, you can link your files to the page you are working on. You can link more than one file using the hyperlink option. Switch on your computer and open the writer file using any of the methods taught to you. Let us now begin today's class. First of all, go ahead and type the paragraph being shown to you. Have you typed out the paragraph? Now, apply any formatting on this paragraph. Let us now practice all the options of the standard toolbar one by one. Firstly, go ahead and show how you will hide the options for Save, Export as PDF, New, and Open from the standard toolbar. If you come across any difficulty in doing this, then watch the video and learn from it. Let us watch this video and learn how we can hide the various options of the standard toolbar. So to hide the options like New, Open, PDF, etc. from the standard toolbar, you have to bring your pointer to the right side of the standard toolbar and click on this drop-down button. From the options available, click on Customize option. A box opens and now you can just keep clicking on the options that you want to hide, so that the tick mark is not there. So we have clicked on New, Open, Save, Then we scroll down and click on export directly as PDF options. So like this, you can keep clicking and you can see that the from the standard toolbar, those options are hidden. Click on OK and you can see from your standard toolbar, those options with the tick marks you have removed or which you had unselected have been hidden. So this is how you can hide the options from the standard toolbar. Next, show how can you once again bring back or show the options for save, export as PDF, new and open of the standard toolbar that you may have hidden earlier. If you come across any problem in doing this, then watch the video and learn. Watch this video now to understand how we can bring back or show any hidden options of the standard toolbar and how we can customize the standard toolbar. To do so, bring your pointer here on the right side of the toolbar. Click on the drop-down button and then click on customize option. Then from the options which are shown here, keep selecting the options that you want to show. For instance, we have clicked on new, then we have clicked on open, then we have clicked on save. The tick marks appear and you can see in the standard toolbar, these options also appear. You can scroll up or down. This time we have selected the export directly as PDF option. That has appeared. Then we click on OK. And this is how you can bring back the options that you want to show in your standard toolbar. And also, this is how you can customize your standard toolbar, as is being shown in the video. Next, show how will you save your file. In case of any doubt, watch the video. Let us now watch this video and learn how we can save a file using the icon of the standard toolbar. So to save the writer file, we take our pointer to the save icon of the standard toolbar. Click on that, a box opens, and now you should know where you want to save the file, at which location on your computer. There are various locations here, like the desktop, downloads, documents, etc. So you should know where you want to save. We have clicked on desktop, so we are going to save this file on desktop. Next, bring your pointer to the file name line and type a name for the file with which name you want to save this file. For example, in the video, CS1 is being written as the file name. Then click on save. And as soon as you click on save, your file gets saved as CS1 with that name on the desktop. You can also see in the title bar here that the CS1 name of the file has appeared, which also means that your file has been saved. So this is how you can use the save icon. Now, bring up a new page and using the hyperlink option, show how you will bring up the saved file on this new page. If you face any problems, learn by watching the video. Let us watch this video and see how the icon in the standard toolbar can be used to apply hyperlinks on our writer file. So you can connect or apply hyperlinks for many files to the same writer file. To do this, you have to bring your cursor or the pointer. For this, we need to bring our pointer to the new icon of the standard toolbar. Left click on that. A new page for writer opens. So you can connect or apply hyperlinks for many files to the same writer file. Your cursor or the pointer to the standard toolbar where the hyperlink icon is there and click on that. A box opens. Click on documents. And then you have to bring your pointer to this icon here, which shows a folder, and click on it. You will see that it opens another box where the location of the file on your computer is shown. So you should know which file from which location you want to bring and connect as a hyperlink. It could be in desktop, it could be in downloads, documents. So right now we are looking at desktops. Then we click on the file that we want and click on OK. Then we click on the second box closes. We have to click on apply and you will see what you can also do before clicking on apply is in the text column and or in the line where the text is written, you can write the name that you want to give to your hyperlink. And you can see in the writer file, a hyperlink has already been applied as a hyperlink has been applied on your writer file. Show how you can use the document as email option, but remember that your document should be in PDF format. If you face a problem, watch the video. Let us now watch this video and see how we can use document as email. So we first bring our pointer to the document as email icon. Click on that. And you will see a box will appear, which is actually the email screen. So for using document as email, you should be having a Microsoft Outlook account with you. So here, if you use attach item, you can attach a file or any other items. As is being shown in the video, since we want to attach a file, we are just closing this and you can click on the attach file option. When you click on the attach file option, a box opens which shows you different locations on the computer. So to attach a file, you should know where your file is located. Is it in desktop, download, etc.? So you click on desktop because your file is located here. You had saved it here and then scroll up and down and select the file. For instance, in the video, we are selecting CS file and then click on the insert option. You will see that the attached column or the line shows that the file gets attached. Next, you will type the email ID of the person or the organization to whom you want to send this email. Like here we are typing connect@computershiksha.org. Then you can also type any subject relevant to this file, and also you can type a message in the message area and then click on send, and your email will get sent with the file being attached. This is how you will use the document as email. Next, show how will you convert your document into PDF format. Watch the video if you have a doubt. Let us now watch this video and see how we can convert a writer file into PDF format. To do this, we need to bring a pointer to the PDF icon of the standard toolbar, export as PDF. Click on that. A box opens. You should know the location where you want to save as PDF your file. Desktop, documents, downloads. So we select desktop and then type the file name with which you want to save it as PDF. You can see below the file name, it is already being saved as PDF file. So click on save and it gets saved as PDF. To see whether this file has been saved at the location, just minimize this file, and then on the desktop, since we had saved it on desktop, you can see the file saved with the name Bharat that we had used. If you double click on this, the file will open. Now if you try to do some editing or add something here, you will notice that you cannot, because it's a PDF file. This is how you will use the PDF option. Now show how will you lock the standard toolbar. Again, watch the video if you find this difficult. Watch this video now to see how we can lock and unlock the standard toolbar. By lock, what happens is that the standard toolbar cannot be moved to any different position. To lock the standard toolbar, bring the pointer to this drop-down button on the right side of the standard toolbar. Click on it and you can see that the lock toolbar position option has not been selected. Once you select it, a tick mark appears and the standard toolbar gets locked, which means that now you cannot move the standard toolbar from its position. On the left side, the dots also disappear or get hidden. So this shows that the standard toolbar is now locked. If you want to unlock the standard toolbar, you will once again have to bring your pointer to the right side of the standard toolbar, click on the drop-down button, and then unselect the lock toolbar option. The tick mark will disappear. And you can also see that on the left side of the toolbar, the dots appear, which shows that now the standard toolbar is unlocked. And by clicking on those dots, you can now move or drag the standard toolbar to any place that you want to bring it to. This is how you will use locking and unlocking the standard toolbar. Next, show how you can bring the standard toolbar below the formatting toolbar, and then also how you can bring the formatting toolbar to a different position. Watch the video and learn more about doing this. With the help of this video, we are now going to see how we can pick and place the formatting toolbar and the standard toolbar in different positions. For this, as is being shown in the video, you will bring your cursor to the left side of the standard toolbar. As soon as you bring the cursor there, it changes into a four-headed arrow, and then you can drag your toolbar to any position that you like. As is being shown in the video, we are keeping the standard toolbar below the formatting toolbar here, and once you release the cursor, which has been pressed to drag the toolbar, it gets placed there. So this is how you can interchange the position of the standard toolbar and the formatting toolbar. Next, show how will you use the spelling and grammar option. For doing this, type out the line shown to you. Computer is an electronic machine which makes our work easier. If in doubt, watch the video. With the help of this video, we are now going to learn how we can use the spelling and grammar option to correct our spellings. First, take the cursor to the underline option to remove the underline, and then type this line which is being shown to you as it is. Remember, we are actually making some mistakes in typing the spelling of the words, like computer is spelled C-O-M-P-T-E-R. Type it with the mistake. Type this line with the mistakes being shown so that we can later use the spelling and grammar option to correct the same. So computer is an electronic machine which makes our life. That is what we are trying to type, but we are making the mistakes as is being shown here. You can notice that whenever the word is wrongly spelled, a red curved underline appears below that. Computer is an electronic machine which makes our work easier. Then select the first word which is wrong or highlighted with the red line. Bring your cursor to this ABC option, and as soon as you click there, a box opens and it shows you the sentence with the word computer in red. Select the correct spelling from the spellings which are shown as alternatives and then click on change. The next word which is wrong gets highlighted, which is electronic. Again, select the correct word, click on change. The next word which is wrong gets highlighted in red, machine. Select the correct spelling, click on that, and then click on the change option. Again, the next word is shown which is wrongly spelled and the options are given. Click on the correct spelling and click on change. Similarly here, makes, so we have to select the correct spelling for make. And once it is complete, a small window appears saying the spell check is complete. You can click on OK. This way you can use the spell check. Next, show how will you use the options for copy, cut and paste. In order to show this, select two lines and bring them to a new place. If there is any difficulty, watch the video. Let us now see how we can use the options of the standard toolbar to copy and paste. For this, as is being shown in the video, we select two lines of our paragraph as shown here, and then we take our pointer to the standard toolbar copy option and click on the copy option, so that these two lines get copied. Next, we bring our cursor to the position where we want to paste this. Click there and then click on the paste option. And you will see that the lines that you had copied get pasted there. This is how you can use the standard toolbar options to copy and paste. Next, use undo to correct this. Now, divide your paragraph into two parts and change the font color and the writing style on the first part. Next, use the option for format paint brush to get formatting on the second part, which is similar to the formatting done on the first part. Watch the video to clear any doubts you may have. With the help of this video, we are now going to learn how we can use the format paintbrush option of the standard toolbar to copy the format from one paragraph to the other paragraph on our text. For this, we have chosen or selected a paragraph as is being shown in the video. We have selected this first paragraph. Now we can make some format changes on this. For instance, we are changing the color of the font. We are also changing the style of the writing or the font size or the font style. So we have selected one of the different fonts which is being shown in this option. Next, we select the format paintbrush option in the standard toolbar and then select the second paragraph on which we want to copy the format of the first paragraph. So now, as soon as you select the second paragraph, you will notice that all the format of the first paragraph has been applied on the second paragraph. This is how you will use the format paintbrush option of the standard toolbar. Now, practice the use of decrease indent and increase indent. Watch the video if you face a problem. With this video, we will now see how we can use the decrease indent or increase indent option of our formatting toolbar. For this, we first have to place the cursor in front of the line, in the beginning of the line where we want to increase or decrease the indent. So click there, like in the last line we are showing in the video. Then take your pointer to the increase indent and click on it. The more you click on it, you will notice that the line keeps moving towards the right side, away from the left margin. So this is how you can use the increase indent. And if you want to decrease the indent, you will click on the decrease indent option in the formatting toolbar. If you keep clicking, the indent will keep becoming lesser. And you can keep going even beyond the margin. If you want to increase the indent, you will click on the increase indent till you are satisfied that your line is in the right position. This is how you can use the increase indent and decrease indent option of the formatting toolbar. You will now learn how to customize the standard toolbar and the formatting toolbar. Can you tell how these toolbars can be customized? To customize the standard toolbar or formatting toolbar, you will need to click on the drop-down button appearing on the right side of the toolbars. This shows you many options which are available, and you can use those to customize these toolbars to suit your needs. Let us all watch this video to learn more about how such customization can be done. With the help of this video, let us now see how we can customize our standard toolbar or the formatting toolbar. So to customize the toolbar, you need to take your pointer to the right side of the toolbar and click on the drop-down button. As is being shown in the video, we are doing it for the standard toolbar. Click there and you can see options here. Click on the customize toolbar and a box opens which shows all the options of the toolbar. Now, some of the options have a tick mark, and those options are already available in the toolbar. If you untick them, those options will disappear from the toolbar. Scroll up or down for the options. So we have unticked export directly as PDF. That goes away from our toolbar. You can also choose the category. For instance, we have chosen pictures in the toolbar. Then we can choose new, and if we want, we can even change the name, or we can choose the same name, new toolbar one, and click on OK. And then we can click on add to add different categories of the pictures or what we want to choose. So from the category option, you can scroll up and down, click on the one which you like. For instance, we want to use edit. Then from the comments, click on the ones which you want and click on add option. Like we have used can't undo. Next we are choosing color palette. Click on add. Copy. Click on add. So these categories keep getting added to the toolbar that we are creating. So you have seen here they get added. Then you can close this and then click on OK. So you will see just above your toolbar, these categories have been added for color palette, for delete row, whatever we had chosen there. So this way you can change or customize your toolbar, the standard toolbar. Again, formatting toolbar, we click on the down arrow and from the options, choose the customize option. Again, the moment we untick the options being shown here, these options keep getting removed. For instance, we have removed bold, italic and underline. So they are no longer present in our toolbar. Then we click on OK and you can see that all the options that we had unticked are no longer available in our formatting toolbar. You can't see bold, you can't see italics or underline here. If you want to bring them back again, you will again click on the drop down button and choose the customize option. So this is how you will customize your standard toolbar or the formatting toolbar. Since we will now end this class, close your file and properly shut down your computer. In today's class, you revised what you had learned in the previous class and also learned how you can customize the standard toolbar and the formatting toolbar. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Thank you.